Dr. Kalani Brady from the John A. Byrne School of Medicine joins us as he does every Thursday, 6:50, and then later again at 7:20. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Okay, somebody is looking for a new doctor. He is 62. What do you recommend? Do your recommendations have anything, is it influenced by this person's age?
Yes, it is. As a matter of fact, this person probably wants an internist, a primary care physician who studied internal medicine, for example, like myself, and or a family medicine doctor if he has a whole family that he's considering having this doctor see. Internists are really well prepared for a broad variety of health recommendations and illnesses, and so I'm biased, but I'm rather proud of them. How do you find the right one? Honolulu Magazine annually has best doctors in Honolulu. You can look on that list. Queens and Straub have referral lines. You can call Queens or Straub and ask them for a referral, and they can give you a referral to a doctor in internal medicine.
Internist.
Yep.
Not like the interns working in the newsroom.
Correct.
I recently had a kidney infection without having a sign of a UTI. How can that be?
You can have a UTI without any signs.
Okay.
And I suspect this person had the kidney infection because they did have an asymptomatic UTI. No knowledge that they had it, but then it ascended into the kidney.
You can have a UTI without signs, mm-hmm. like burning and blood and
right.
all that kind of stuff?
Right.
That seems
an
like it could be dangerous.
Without irritation.
Yeah.
Yep, exactly. I have a couple of patients like that, and they end up in the emergency room from an early kidney infection because they didn't know to treat the bladder infection.
Right, okay. A woman called in to say she's 74 and her white blood cell count is a little low. Is it a cause for concern, and what caused this?
First of all, you'd want to know what was happening to that white cell count over time. Has it always been low, or is this a new finding? Secondly, there are some diseases that result in a low white blood count, and you should ask your doctor about working you up for those diseases. But a lot of people who have a slightly low white blood count are fine, and a slightly low white blood count does not make you more susceptible to disease. That's very important.
Okay. All right. We're going to join Dr. Brady again in another half an hour at 7:20, so you can get your questions ready at that time.